Hello, we are back in time for our next scheduled presentation. I'm going to add Nicolas Roland to the stream in a minute to watch his talk and presentation titled One Arabesque in the Small World of OD Web Maps. So Nicolas is a GIS engineer at Gustave Eiffel University in France. And Nicola is also a project steering committee member of the OSTEO-LIBE project and OSTEO-FR, the French-speaking chapter of OSTEO. So I'm adding him to the stream right now. Nicola, welcome. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. Thank you. Thank you for this kind introduction. Thank you all for your attentions today.
Thank you. You are a great conference goer, so lots of comments, lots of good comments, lots of participation. So thank you for that.
Thank you. I will be speaking today about a paper we wrote with I'm Nicolas Roland, obviously from the University Gustave Eiffel, and I will be speaking about a paper we wrote with Françoise Bahoken, Grégoire Le Campion, Laurent Gégou, Marion Maisonneuve, Boris Mérisquet, and Étienne Côme, which are part of the University Gustave Eiffel or other research team in France, about OD web maps application. So this work is part of the JFOVIS project. We can find more information about it on its hypothèse.org blog. And this project focuses on web application that can do thematic geolocalization and for cartographic purposes, and especially on flows and spatial network mapping. So this is the general context of the project. We did a review of existing tools since 2016. We reviewed around 90 tools, different tools. We also conduct a survey of around 200 users in the field, and this led to the development of the Arabesque application in 2018, and I will be speaking a little bit more about this application. So, why I made a comparison of OD web maps application? First goal was to determine the strengths and weaknesses of Arabesque compared to other applications in the area. So, we can determine where Arabesque positions itself. Regarding our application, this is also because we made a special effort on rendering and data analysis, and we wanted to know if it's still innovative. And we hope that this paper, this work, will help users to make an informed choice. So, on which criteria did we choose those applications? We focused on applications that are similar to Arabesque. So we focused on web applications that are available online. So no desktop application like QGIS. It has to be free and open source software. It has to provide origin destination data visualization capabilities. And it has to have to provide the ability for the user to use its own data. So we focuses on four applications, obviously Arabesque, but we also compare it to FlowMap.blue, Kepler.gl, and Magritte. We also thought about the Flourish application. But it's very similar. It uses the exact same technology than Kepler.gl, so it has the same limitations and strength. So, but provide another nice interface. But so we discard it because it doesn't bring new things. Let's talk about those application. Arabesque was launched in 2019. It's part of the JFOVIS project, as I said, and its main goal is the exploration and geolocalization of origin destination flows. I will do a small demo at the end if we have some time. We also compare to FlowMap Blue, which was created in 2019 by Ilya Boyandin, data visualization engineer. And it also, its goal is to explore and create flow maps as well. So it's very close to Arabesque in this way. We also compare it to Kepler.gl, launched in 2018. It's more general tool for, it's designed for complex data sets. So you can do flow maps, but you can do all kind of maps inside. And we also compare to Magritte, which was launched in 2017 by the RIAD team, another French research team. It's a more general thematic cartography tool where you can also create flow maps. Let's talk a little bit about our data and the data model. Most applications use comat separated values files. For some applications, you can use GeoJSON files for the node, but most applications use CSV file. The data storage has to be in wide, large matrix format, which is a more frequent format in this. And the node has to be in WJS84, so in lat-long coordinates, at the exception of Magritte, which can also use projected data. Please note that any of those applications provides cleaning tools, so you have to clean and prepare your data before loading them. And please note that Arabesque provide a message and telling you how many and which nodes or links are removed because they are orphaned. We prepare a small data set. It's a data set of French student mobilities in 2017 made by the French Statistics Bureau. And it's mobilities of elementary school and two grad school students. So it's more than 4 billion records. And it's a little, it's too much for some applications. So we had, if we want to compare exactly with the same data, we had to aggregate it to a more coarse level. We choose the department level, which is a large, administrative area in France, and we reduce the data set to 27,000 records. So the knowledge we extract from this comparison. So the usage, we think you, for several usage, you can choose several applications. Of course, for the representation of flow maps, you can use all of those four applications. But if you want more styling option and advanced graphics, you might want to use Arabesque and Magritte, for example. If you want to explore your map, you can use Arabesque and Kepler and FlowMap Blue. Magritte is not, you can't zoom in and zoom out in your map. It's a static map generator, so you can't really explore your map like we can do, like we can see in the video. Please note that Arabesque and FlowMap Blue have some nice features for multiscalar visualization. So Arabesque styles adapt to the scale. And FlowMap Blue has an aggregation mechanism where you zoom out, the links aggregates, and you zoom in, they are deaggregates. It's very nice features you might want to try. If you want to do more data analysis or data exploration, we recommend to use Arabesque or Kepler.gl because, as you can see, and as I will show you later, there is some possibilities to filter the data with histograms and windows, moving windows. I will show you that. So you can work on your data a little bit more than in the application. For which purposes and public we think whose applications are best suited? If you want to do data exploration and visualization, if you are in the general public or maybe a data journalist, if you, especially if you want to publish on the web, we recommend you to use Kepler.gl or FlowMapBlue because they are more suited for this kind of public and or purpose. If you are in the academia and you are doing research or teaching, especially if you want to do some thematic maps production or have statistical analysis capabilities within the app, we think Arabesque and Magrit are best suited for those purposes. Let's talk a bit about performance, because like I said, we had to aggregate the data in order to be able to use it to create a data set usable in those four applications seamlessly. So Kepler.gl and FlowMapBlue are based on DocGL. They work with very large data sets, very, very fast. They provide limited graphic options. When we say large data sets, one of my co-authors, Boris, load the 4 billion rows data in Kepler.gl, and it was working very fine. So it works very, very well with large data sets. In the other end, Arabesque and Magrit use the D3 JavaScript library, and it doesn't work with very, very large data sets. But it provides more styling option. So if you want more control on your styling, we think Arabesque is best suited. Let's talk about interoperability and reproducibility. The data formats are CSV and or GeoJSON, so it's well-known data formats. Most of those applications use two separate tables, one for the link and one for the node, at the exception of Kepler.gl, which use just one file with only the link and the origin coordinates and the destination coordinates in four columns. So you have to prepare a little bit your data beforehand. But you can use the same exact file for Arabesque, Magrit, and FlowMapBlue. In the export, we find there is very nice feature in those applications. For example, Kepler.gl and FlowMapBlue allows online hosting, so you can share and do some web publishing with it. If you want to export images for maybe a paper, you can use Arabesque and Magrit, of course. And the very, very nice feature we found is that Arabesque, Kepler.gl, and Magrit allows you to export the data and the project parameters and save your project. So you can reuse it or share it with a coworker or someone else. I will show you something like that. It allows the reproductivity of all the processing, so you can find the parameters of the project and of the map. And we think it's very important in the context of open science. We have today a keynote about open science by Anissa Grazer, so I invite you to follow it. In conclusion, we think that business culture, user skills, and final use of the map influence the choice of the tool, because you will choose a different approach. Maybe it's you want to do more exploration or more analysis and choose a tool accordingly. We demonstrate that the data does not inform the choice of the tool, at least in this panel. And all those four applications cover the whole range of needs and possibilities, and which this is for the benefits of the whole community. Thank you for your attention. You can reach me by email or on Twitter. You can access the application on arabesque.istar.fr, and you can access the preprint version of this if you can share the link with you. I will do a little, I have a couple minutes to do a little demonstration. It will take some time to do that. So let's load a data set. So I'm the Arabesque Phosphor G 2021 GitHub repo, Git repo, sorry. And in the data and projects folder, we have this zip file called save jflovis mobsco sub 107. And if I click on open and load afterwards, this share the map. Okay, it's a little bit longer because maybe I'm streaming, because it worked seamlessly this morning. Yeah, so you can zoom in and zoom out and see that it's adapting. So on the left you have the layer panel. When you see, you can have your nodes and links layer, so you can move it and adapt what you like. You have a base map, and this map, it's a base map, Voyager base map. On the layer panel, you can change the styling, so you can have access to several color palettes and change the sizes and things like that, and the node and things like that. It's the same for the link, but you can also change the type. Maybe you want to use a triangle, and there's some issues with the color. Okay, there is some issue with the color, and the application is not responding very well because maybe of the streaming. This is the layer panel. You can add new layer, eventually reproject your data. And on the left, you have your filter panel, where you can filter your data according to a window and on a small histogram. Then you can add, the node. Okay, let's add a little filter. So you can see there is several variables that are from the dataset, but some are computed by the application. The balance is the difference flow between in and out. You can compute, it computes also the number of connections, so the degree, in degree and out degree. And this is the weighted counterparts of those new variables. So let's choose the balance. It's a numeral, but you can see you can have categorical and things like that. And you can also choose. So maybe I want just only positive links or negative links, and it will be updating accordingly. Thank you for your attention. I'm available for questions.
Thank you, Nicola, for the presentation and also the demo. I can say that I have bookmarked this to have a look at, etc., because I'm quite interested in, for example, using other visualization methods, etc., in the class, etc. I'm thinking that Sterling is also might be interesting, because after this presentation, he's going to present a talk titled "Using Free and Open Source Software to Teach University JS Courses Online." So he may be having a look at it as well. There's one question. Is it possible to have the OD connections on the road network as well? So we are seeing direct links, but can we integrate the transportation network on that if you want to do that?
Not at the moment, sorry. It's not how the application works. It just use node coordinates and create the link accordingly to the node coordinates. So it takes one origin node and one destination node and create a link between those two nodes. So it doesn't take the transportation or the road in account.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for the information. I had other questions, but you always answered those by comparing other tools, etc. So it was a great presentation. Thank you. If you want to add something, if you have any additional comments, etc., you can use that time to have.
Yeah. If I have some time more, so we in 20 minutes we can't speak about everything in the paper and be.
We may have 3 or 4 minutes more.
Yeah, so there is more information about the data set and how we made it, and more information and more capture. But we also, this create a diagram to explain how this application works. So how does it work and where it gets the data, if it does aggregation, where it's combining whose information into an origin destination matrix, if it does compute new values and new new statistics, and then display the information. So you can choose a map type, and you can style and add a layout and things like that. And we spent several hours working on this and thinking of it. So it can be very insightful, I think, to read also the paper, just not extract information from the presentation. So, and we explain every not as we said in detail, but the important steps in each. So the paper is very good complement to the presentation. The other way around. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. I have also shared the links on the tool, on the paper, and also a presentation to the chat at venues. So the attendees, the people watching the presentation, can go and access there. And just please feel free to get in touch with Nicola after the presentation as well if you have any further questions. I think I may have after trying out the tool. So thanks a lot for the effort. It's great. Thanks for presenting.
Yeah, thank you, Ken.
Thank you. So
have a good weekend.
Thank you. Thanks, you too. Have a nice rest of the conference and have a nice weekend. Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Okay, so in 4 or 5 minutes, we are going to come back and we will have Sterling Quinn for his presentation. But until then, we have 5 minutes to spare. So if you want to go get some air, if you want to grab a coffee, tea, etc., you're more than welcome. So see you in 4 minutes.